Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, this is an honor for me to be here with you today and to share our opinions in order to promote cooperation worldwide. This is important because the dependency of the countries are increasing. If we look at the picture of 1945, there were few countries. Now the number of the countries increased to 193. Only 31 of them were created after 1990. It means more nations, more cooperation. There's no other way. If we look at the population in the world, Turkey is in the mid. We have a population of 75 million. 2 billion are living in China and in India. We are not far from this area. According to the calculations of the next 2 decades, energy consumption will be a big deal in the world. Example, the analysts are calculating in 2035, China will consume 70% more energy than the United States, not per capita, the total consumption. But per capita consumption in the United States will continue to remain higher than the per capita consumption in China. But the need for energy resources are increasing. Why is Turkey important? 70% of the energy resources are around this country. In the Middle East, in Central Asia, there are confrontations, interest, conflicts of interests. We are on the Western side, ally of NATO, NATO, and we are cooperating in NATO. The confrontation could be diminished or softened only by balancing the powers. If you cannot balance the powers, the confrontation is increasing. We were with my friend Mark Pritchard yesterday, since the beginning of the week, in the UN to negotiate the arms trade treaty. And we were trying to reach consensus, for example. Great Britain, Turkey, United States of America, and many other countries in our region were hoping to reach a consensus. What happened at the last moment? Last moment, Syria, Iran, and North Korea, 3 countries, as far as I remember, blocked the consensus. But the agreement will be adopted next week in the General Assembly of the United Nations, but it doesn't matter. You see the picture. There is a crisis now in Syria. This crisis is affecting not reaching the consensus. Russian Federation is not speaking, it's silent. If you look at the cooperation between the Russian Federation and China concerning the Syria, you see the picture. Russian Federation is influencing the Iran decision, is not speaking, but Iran is opposing. And China is influencing the decision of North Korea. China is not speaking. The other one is blocking the system. This type of developments are happening many times in the region, and therefore the tight cooperation is needed in order to improve the climate. In the next decades, next two decades, the non-OECD countries will be will consume more energy. The increase in population will be more in that area, and the output, the increase in output, economic development will be also outside of the more outside of the OECD countries because of the big population. As I said, China and India altogether, in China and India, more than 2 billion people will live. The countries such as Turkey, United States of America, Israel, and Great Britain should work in the Middle East in a very constructive way in order to diminish the tensions on the one side, on the other side, to end this turmoil in the region. The statements of the statement are therefore very important. I experienced both sides. I was elected from the government party. Now I'm in the opposition. The reason is not national. The reason is international. Because I was not agreeing with some of the international statements. Example, if you emphasize one thing or one point too much, you are causing a radicalization of the system. All the countries, all the governments can make mistakes. We are making mistakes. The others can make also mistakes. This is another thing. But every nation has the right to vote for their own government. If you want to criticize a mistake, you criticize the mistake. But if you emphasize the name of the country more, this is causing a radicalization. You say, I'm anti-Semitic as a politician. At the same time, you criticize too much Israel, for example. In this case, the perception is changing. Because the people understand if you criticize Israel, this is a type of rhetoric which is helping to anti-Semitism and so on. You should be very careful in that case. We are very good historical experience with the populations in the Middle East, with Israel, with Jewish population, with Israel. We are one of the countries recognized very early the state of Israel. Although this is the case, we are experiencing the rhetoric problem of rhetoric. Example, expression of Zionism. Zionism, you like or not, this is another thing, but this is a philosophy of to form a state. This is a philosophy. And in Turkey, I am coming from a nationalist movement party. You can reshape, you can say, okay, nationalism should be interpreted in that way or in that way. It should not be racial. It should be more national. It should not based on concept of races. It should based on concept of coexistence and cooperation. But sometimes we experienced that, for example, the statement of the Prime Minister, of our Prime Minister, was not found in a right way. It was a wrong statement. He corrected. But once you say something, once you correct the other day, the effects are not eroded. The effects are there. You cannot, you should be very, you cannot erase all of these effects. Politicians should be more careful in order to strengthen the cooperation. I'm sharing another view than the Prime Minister, therefore I left his party. My view is, I emphasize more on individual freedom than on rights of groups. My emphasis. Prime Minister is emphasizing more rights for groups. The end, if the Prime Minister is making, my Prime Minister is making a statement on Israel, Israel will be understood as group, not as an individual area and so on. This was one point of disagreement. The other point of disagreement, we are not selecting our neighbors. Our neighbors are there. Many minorities are living together. For example, in Syria, 45% of the population is composed of minorities. If you create a problem in Syria, all the experienced radical groups are coming there and are fighting to each other. You are not helping to diminish the radicalization. You are helping to increase the radicalization. Although these problems are on the table, we experience an apology between Turkey and Israel. Why? We are good friends. We should be good friends. And our ambassador, Turkish ambassador, was saying, only good friends apologize to each other. This is important. If you are not good friends, it is more difficult. But in the past, we have an experience of an empire. This was in the past. We should look forward. In the future, there is no ambition to form an empire. As I said, the number of the countries are not decreasing. Is not decreasing. The number of countries is increasing. It means more freedom, more cooperative approach, but less empire philosophy. The prime the foreign minister worked in my university. We worked with him together. But he's emphasizing more this empire experience than respecting the sovereignty of the countries in the region. But in any way, apology is helping us now to strengthen the, on the one side to strengthen the relations once again, on the other side to create an alternative to improve the distribution of energy resources. This is very important. If you look at the hate of Turkey, in a hate of 2,000 meters or 3,000 meters, you will see sea stones. Stones came from the sea. It means in the past, Turkey was a sea. Turkey, on the other side, the lands came together from the Mediterranean side and from the Black Sea side, and Black Sea became a sea, Mediterranean basin became another sea. What is the meaning of that? There are many interesting resources in the middle, in the Mediterranean Sea and in the Black Sea. In the Black Sea. Now Turkey is in the mid of Mediterranean Sea and Black Sea. And other resources could be expected also in Turkey. Now, Turkey is on the one side a bridge, a passage between the supplier countries and consumer countries on the one side. On the other side, Turkey has a role to break the monopoly of some countries. Example, in order to break the monopoly of the Russian Federation in the gas supply to the European Union, you should cooperate with another one, whether with Israel or with Qatar or with the other supplier countries. And you see, Turkey can play a role to balance the system. If the monopoly is not good for the world cooperation, for the worldwide cooperation, and now Turkey is helping, could be more constructive in that way. But there are prerequisites to be more constructive. You should have a very constructive understanding. Turkey developed its economy in a very good way in the past years. But in the foreign policy, our foreign minister followed a policy of zero problem. A policy of zero problem. In foreign policy, there is no zero problem. Bunch of problems, full of problems. Foreign policy is composed of problems. Problems are used sometimes as mechanism to negotiate. Example, Russian Federation is doing it. In order to create a balance in the Central Asia, they are applying a low-profile crisis policy. Sometimes creating a crisis helped them to keep the nations together. I was two times observer in the elections in Moldova, for example. In Moldova, there are Turks, Christian Turks, not Muslim Turks, Christian Turks. Therefore, Turkey can have a constructive role to enhance the relations, for example, with Moldova in a better way. if you cooperate in a right wing. Georgia, we have at least 2 million people living in Turkey, Georgians living in Turkey, they are Muslims. The Georgians who are in Georgia are Christians in general. This is the same example such as in Tiran, Albania, in Albania. In Albania, all the Albanians living in Albania are Christians. All Albanians living outside of Albania are Muslims. In general, there are exceptions. But what is doing that one? Turkey has a population of Albanians. The writer of our national song is an Albanian. In such a way, without looking at their religion, you are looking at their friendship, because you are living together. And this is the same for Georgia. Without looking at their religions, you are looking at their cooperation. Now Turkey is very influential in Georgia because of the Georgian population. And Turkey has a significant population coming from Azerbaijan, and also a significant population coming from Central Asia. This is a composition. Turkey is a composition of the groups coming from different parts. This is a real example in order to show the coexistence possibilities in the country, if you do it in a right way. The same is valid for the Jewish population. There was an immigration because of the formation of Israel, especially from Ukraine and from Turkey. The number was 90,000. At that time, more than 90,000, because in the Second World War, most of them came to the Turkish universities or lived in Turkey. Later on, some of them left for the States, for the other European countries, but in general for Israel. Now we have almost 25,000. But there is a very visible example. There are many Jewish companies in Turkey producing refrigerators, for example, producing other tools, other products. In Turkey, nobody is asking who is producing what. If it is useful, they are buying. In all the Muslim houses, you see the refrigerators produced by a Jewish company. You see, there is no policy such as apartheid policy in South Africa. There is no such a policy. It is easier to be constructive in Turkey, even there are mistakes. Now, there was a mistake, in my opinion, to reduce the relations, to slow down, let's say, the political relations with Israel, between Israel and Turkey. Although political relations were not in a level which we wish, but there was no effect, no negative impact on the trade volume. Trade is an important factor to combine the people. But in the tourism sector, there were problems because of the of this Marmara this ship case. Yes, flotilla case. Now there is more request than before to cooperate, because turmoil in the Arabic Spring, turmoil in the Arabic world because of the Arabic Spring, is bringing more radicalization in the systems. The people were expecting 2 years ago this turmoil will be ended in 2 years or in 1 year. No problem. You will change one leader, the other leader will be replaced. Now the people will get more rights. At the end, more democracy, everything will be like a garden with flowers and everything. But it is not the real picture. The real picture, if you fight, you are gaining enemies. If you are gaining also friends and enemies. And if you can balance, or if you can guarantee that you gain more friends than enemies, you are on the right side. But if you decrease the number of enemies and the number of friends and increase the number of enemies, the confrontation is the result. Now, the confrontation possibility in the Middle East is not less than before because of the radical groups. Look at Syrian case. All the well-experienced groups in other areas of the world, in Afghanistan or in another area, came now to experience, to show their experiences to Syria. They are fighting each other. And now the opposition is not able to find a common way. You are electing, for example, a president, a prime minister on exile. This prime minister is not recognized, not by the other countries, but by their own rivals. This is a problem. Now, therefore, it is not a right way to think, in my opinion. Okay, if we get rid of Assad, we can solve all of the problems. No, this is not the case. You should be able to stay, to sit down on the table with all the interesting or all the influential partners. Who are these partners? Iran is supporting. Russian Federation is supporting. Russian Federation has a base in Tartus. Doesn't want to leave the Mediterranean base. On why? Energy monopoly will be lost if Russian Federation cannot control the supply routes. Germany and Russian Federation cooperated, for example, to supply Russian gas to the European Union. At the same time, Russian Federation is interested in avoiding the supply of the Qatar gas to the European Union, because if Qatar is supplying 10% now of the gas, and the monopoly will be broken. Now there is another event. Israel discovered new gas resources, and the gas resources around the island, Cyprus island, is too big. Now Turkey is becoming more important, because the shortest way to supply the gas, to break the monopoly position of the Russian Federation, is is important, but a cooperation is needed. Unless you cooperate with the island, with Cyprus, and with Israel, you cannot be more efficient. This is the problem. Okay, there are many problems, but I don't want to go further in details. It is better to answer the questions.
I have a question.
Yes.
I wonder. I'm very curious about the recent PKK developments with the Kurdish radicals. I was reading something and they were suggesting that perhaps Erdogan was doing this because he is interested in getting Kurdish support in the parliament for a stronger executive presidency in 2014. And that would be one reason why he's trying to, there may be some olive branch between the PKK and the government. And I'm wondering if you would comment on that.
Okay, thank you very much for the question. First of all, Turkey developed the ties with the northern Iraq, Kurdish populated northern Iraq. At the same time, the relations with the central government of Iraq worsened, because central government of Iraq was supported more by the Iranian side because of the religious factor. The Shia population is high enough in Iraq. The most important energy resources are whether in the northern part, in the Kurdish or Turkish populated parts. These are Mosul and Kirkuk, the old Turkish cities and now Kurdish populated parts altogether. Turkey tried to improve the relations with that area. Now, because of this energy politics, it is a must to find a way to end up with the terrorist activities. Every side is tending to agree, but it is not an easy case. Terror organizations are used by many countries. PKK is also based in Iran. Iran will be more interested now to block or to make more difficult this cooperation, because there is a big competition between the northern line and the central government. Central government will be used more by Iran than by Turkey in that respect. I don't see it will be too easy, but it is a necessity to reach an agreement. But the expectation of the prime minister is rather different. The prime minister is a pragmatic one. His interest is to be president with full power and remain until at least 2023 in power, because 2023 is the anniversary, 100-year anniversary of the formation of the Turkish Republic. he is interested in achieving an agreement in that side. But democracy is not a tool, a real tool for Erdogan, not according to me, according to his own statements. 10 days ago, there was a newspaper interview with King Abdullah of Jordan. King Abdullah is saying, Erdogan said one time to me, democracy is a bus ride, like a bus ride. If you reach your goal, you get out. Until you reach your goal, you can ride the bus. This is not a real approach of the democratization goals of the society. This is a problematic one. It is difficult to calculate his ambitions. If he were too democratic, I would be dead. Now I'm trying to improve the climate to be more democratic. The freedom of expression in Turkey is a problem now. The freedom of expression and freedom of press. This is not the report. These are not the reports from our side. These are the reports from all over the world. We are a country now, unfortunately, it should not be, but it is the case. More journalists in prison than in China. This is a pity, but this is a reality. If you criticize the government's government policies, they cannot throw me out of the parliament, but they are throwing the writers out of the newspapers. They are losing their jobs. This is. Therefore, the ambitions are more important for Erdogan now than the right way of peaceful solution. Yes.
When Erdogan took office in 2002, he started to slowly phase out the generals, replace the generals.
Yes.
And then there was that mass resignation, albeit close to their retirement 2 years ago. What were they saying? What was their statement in doing that, in resigning?
Of generals?
Yes.
Generals in Turkey, the military, was accused to prepare a putsch, a coup d'etat for the Erdogan government. If this is real, we should see the results. If you keep the people 3 years, 4 years in prison, the generals in prison, and if you accuse them, you were collaborating with the terrorist organizations, but you are now dealing with a terrorist, head of the terrorist organization. This is not a fair way of leading the country. Chief of staff is accused to be leader of a terrorist organization, but at the same time, Prime Minister Erdogan is dealing with the head of the terrorist organization. If you want to have the peace, this is another thing. This is good, but if you use European Union standards in order to weaken the army, or in order to weaken the press, who press which is not supporting you, is not the right way. In Turkey, is, as I said, 75 million. The people who are reading newspapers are all exaggerated, highly exaggerated, 5 million. The rest, maybe 15 million, are using internet. 55 million are deciding only by watching the television. And now he's controlling the televisions. This is a policy, but this is not a democracy. And this is the same by the generals. By the generals, I don't know really what is happening. They can be punished, but we should know this punishment, the reasons of this punishment. Yes.
Thank you very much for the interesting view of the geopolitical importance and challenges also facing Turkey. When the Arab Spring occurred and the change of governments of Tunisia, Libya, and even Egypt, there was a lot of talk about looking to Turkey and following the example of the Peace and Justice Party. Has Turkey lost some of the attraction to these countries, and is Turkey in a position to play an important and maybe a bigger role in the Middle East in trying to bring peace,
yes,
greater order,
yes,
and sense to the way the nations act?
Thank you. We are. It is up to you what you want to export. If you export goods and commodities, this is perfect. But if you want to export democracy, democracy is not something which is exportable. Democracy is something which should be perceived and which should be really understood. Now, Turkey was against importing or against importing radical regimes, especially from Iran. This is okay, but on the other side, you cannot try to export other democratic values. Democratic values are common values. And we are eager to see everywhere democratic values. We should support, but if you intervene in the decision of the people and you are coming to a radicalization point and like criticizing Israel, Israel government is doing something and you say, okay, I want to see justice, I want to see the freedom, I want to see that and that in the region. And you are not the leader of the whole region. This is a perception of being a leader of the whole region. We are not interested in being the leader of the whole region. We are interested in cooperating with the leaders of the region. But this is the main point which I oppose. Erdogan is said Egypt should look at us. Now Egypt is saying, okay, Morsi, Islamic brother, Muslim brothers are my good friends, and the rest I can send to them to the prison. I can cite some of the incidents I wrote 2 days ago here in the newspapers. He is sending to the prison who are opposing. Erdogan is saying, I don't send them. The justice are sending them. But the Development and Justice Party is the name of the Erdogan party. But development is good. About justice, but justice, there are problems. Now, if they work together, Morsi and Erdogan, they won't export to each other, but with that perception, contribute to the increase of the radical movements.
Thank you very much for your presentation. You've touched on the Kurdish issue, and I'm just curious whether, in your view, looking out at the deep horizon, is there ever going to be a time or a place for the development of a separate Kurdistan as a country? And if not, why not?
This is depending on many different factors, not only on one factor. United States is composed of 52 provinces. Now Erdogan is saying, okay, I want to create in Turkey a similar system. Therefore, I want to have this presidential, to develop a presidential system. As long as the people are ready to live with you, there's no problem. As long as the people are not satisfied, the problems are increasing. But we have a British friend here. They had the problem, Northern Ireland problem. And we have now a Kurdish problem. Both cases are not identical, very different. The people were not marrying to each other at that time, as far as I know, and there were different approaches in the society. In Turkey, the Kurds are everywhere. In Istanbul, in Izmir, in Antalya, everywhere. The marriages between the Turks and Kurds are too high. Only because of the statements, we could be separated, we could have another state. Since these type of statements, in Turkey we are experiencing almost the cut of marriages between the Turks and Kurds. But the Kurds in Turkey are not interested in having another identity. They want to stay in the system, but with the basic rights, language, education, and other rights valid for everyone. And I believe that the decision of the population is determinant, will be determinant, not other factors. But in these days, there is a trend to cooperate also with the northern part of Syria, with the northern part of Iraq, and with the southern part of Turkey. More cooperation approach than willing an independent state. Okay.
I want to ask you maybe one final question.
Yes.
Follow up to your question. Following the Arab Spring, we had expectation in the world from Turkey to become a model of a Muslim state. Can we facilitate a strategic location between East and West, as you described it? My question to you, I understand from your presentation that the current political situation have different motive and different motivation. The question, what about the Turkish people themselves? Do they see themselves as a democratic society or a Muslim society?
In Turkey, the perception is more to be a democratic society than being than requiring a religious, let's say, religious tendency of democratic values. If there are many groups in Turkey, religious, semi-religious, non-religious, or different Muslims, non-Muslims, it is impossible to convert the society to a religious one. The people are believing that Erdogan is too religious, but the applications of Erdogan are not based on religion. Applications of Erdogan are based on practical approaches, not on sophisticated religious approaches. Erdogan is recognizing that being together with the Muslims or feeling together more is bringing more votes. And he's doing, but not the religion. Not the determinant is not the religion. The others are knowing that one too. Therefore, Erdogan's party is gaining also votes from non-religious people. We have in Turkey CHP, a more social democrat party. More social democrat party should have more votes in general. This is the expectation all over the world from the workers, from the poor people, and all the workers and poor people are voting for Erdogan because not because of the religion, because of this pragmatic approach. Okay, thank you.
What are the prospects for Turkey to join the EU, considering the challenges to democracy on the Turkish side and the economic challenges on the EU side?
Erdogan, I was working on the commission, in the Turkish parliament, to harmonize the relations between the EU and Turkey. Erdogan emphasized more the import of values of the European Union than joining. And now if you ask the population, the support is 17%. Too low. This support was in 2004 over 50%. The reasons are lying also in the European side. Example, the Turkish population did not understand why France blocked 5 chapters. Even the people are not knowing. They don't ask which chapters are blocked, but they know one thing. 5 chapters are blocked by France. political reason, not economic reason, not other reasons, political reason. And the population approaches now in a political way, and the support decreased to 70%. And Erdogan is not unhappy from that result. He says, okay, if we have an alternative, he made a statement of Shanghai group. Maybe he's not, I'm sure, he's not believing that he will go to that side, but he is making such statements on pragmatic basis to compete or to have better negotiations.